वक्रतुंड महाकाय सूर्यकोटि समप्रभ निर्विघ्नं कुरु मे देव सर्वकार्येषु सर्वदा
Chairman, sir, the floor is yours.
Thank you. Good evening, friends. First of all, I wish you all a very happy new year, very much in advance. Let's hope 2022 brings in new cheer and lot of positiveness and prosperity. We at BI have always had a positive approach to everything during the pandemic, and it has paid dividends. Our members are all now busy with work. Evident there are some rough patches and corners which BI is tackling. BI approach has always been to keep its members occupied during the pandemic, and the lecture series are one of the methods. We are all today now into the 22nd lecture of BI Mumbai Center monthly lecture series. I am told that the concept of GovTech is a mechanical slicing designed for the connection of precast elements. Each GovTech sleeve features a threaded end used for the connection or to reinforce at the precast factory and cavity for connecting the precast element at site. With the sort of infrastructure construction going on in India and planned in for future, it is very important that we are enlightened about such concepts. The topic mentioned in our announcement has generated a lot of interest, and we all are keen to know more about the concept. I will leave it to the keynote speaker, Sri Satish Priyadarshan, to dwell more upon the concept. So I welcome you to the webinar. I take this opportunity to thank Dextra India Private Limited for partnering with BI in organizing today's webinar. I welcome all the participants who have registered and have joined us. I also welcome the senior functionaries of BI for across BI who are with us now. We also have some international participants, and I welcome them too. I wish you all a very informative evening. Jai Hind, Jai Maharashtra. Now I request Harshaja to introduce the speaker, Sri Satish Priyadarshan. Harshaja, unmute yourself.
Unmute yourself, sir.
Good evening, everyone. Sri Satish Priyadarshan is currently working as Precast Product Line Manager for Messrs. Dextra India Private Limited and is responsible for the firm's Precast Business Indian Region. By qualification, he is a mechanical engineer with a master's in business administration in marketing and finance. He has a varied experience in various industries like heavy metal, metals, nuclear power, and precast. He has overall 13 years' experience in construction industry. He has worked in marquee infrastructure projects in likes of Mangalore Refinery and Petrochemicals Limited, Kudamkulam Nuclear Power Plant, Fast Reactor Fuel Cycle Facility in the Indira Gandhi Center for Atomic Research, and Kalakapam, as well as some of the major precast projects like Amravati Judicial Complex, Express Exclusive, Bosch Bangalore, Galaxy Orbited Hyderabad, Vaishnavi Tech Square, Chennai Silks, AP, Government Jet City, HPCL Rajasthan Refinery Limited, Indian Oil Corporation Limited, Vizag Refinery City, and Industrial Corporation of Maharashtra Sirco, Sea Bird and Water Tanks, to name a few. Thank you.
Sir, over to you, sir. Satish, sir.
Thank you. Thank you for your warm welcome. I hope I'm audible. Am I audible, sir?
Yes, sir.
Okay, so we will be shortly entering our presentation, and thanks for BI for giving me this opportunity. Thank you, everybody, and let me start. Is the screen visible, sir? Is the screen visible, sir? Am I audible?
Yes.
The screen is visible, sir.
Okay. So I will start with a brief introduction of Dextra and what Dextra does, and then we will slowly enter into precast and about the product in specific. So to start with, Dextra is a French company. We are headquartered in Thailand, and we have been operative in India for past 2 decades or 20 years plus in India. So we have 3 locations where we have factories. One is in Thailand, one is in India, and one is in Guangzhou, China. 3 factories are specialized in 3 different product lines. So the Indian factory that you see is the largest coupler manufacturing facility in India. And it's also an export hub for couplers. We manufacture couplers which are exported through this factory throughout the globe. And Guangzhou factory is dedicated to carbon fiber and glass fiber manufacturing. And our Thailand factory is a research hub testing facility plus a steel manufacturing facility. So this is our global footprint, and this is how we are spread. So we are active in 86 plus countries. We have 13 offices, 3 factories span globally. Coming down into products, Dextra has multiple product lines. The main product that we are going to talk about is concrete reinforcement products, CRP products, which basically are couplers, and couplers suited for various applications, various requirement, construction requirement. So when we say couplers, primary work of any coupler remains to provide rebar continuity. So that can be threaded, that can be grouted, that can be crimped, that can be bolted. But ideally, the coupler function remains same. It is to provide continuity of rebar. So now we will have a short view about precast and what precast is about. Precast is basically the moving line assembly of construction industry. So when car manufacturing started, it was done by artisans, where one person used to work in one particular model of a car and it was produced. And slowly the concept of moving line assembly was introduced by Ford Manufacturing, which focused on factory assembly lines to produce and standardize cars and produce in mass volume. The same concept has been introduced in precast. If you see, the second photo that you see is a precast facility, which is basically an assembly lines, and where multiple parts of a building are manufactured and it will be assembled at site. So this is what precast basically does. It splits up your whole building into multiple components, which are manufactured and then taken into site, and then it is assembled. So when we split buildings into multiple formats, and there are multiple products from Dextra which are fitting into different parts of the building. So first we will go into consider what are all the considerations that are taken for a precast building. So first is that, is it a captive project? Is the precast building having a captive plant? Is the location of the plant nearby? Is site accessible? So every precast plant has a range of 200 to 300 kilometers. Beyond that, precast becomes ineffective and transportation cost becomes too high to bear. Are there enough labors to construct? Because when you are going to a precast, even now, if you see, most of the cast in situ buildings are affected by labor migration. And in this COVID situation, it has even increased. Be it Chhat Puja, be it COVID lockdowns, labors often means leave the site, and it becomes a hurdle to progress with the site. And standardization, this is one main thing. But the whole concept of precast revolves around standardization. You cannot have multiple side, different types of walls or columns to proceed with the precast building. When it is precast, everything has to be standardized. You should have one type of column throughout the floor. You should have one type of design everywhere. When you change it, then the number of molds increase. The number of anything you have to multiply. If you have 70 different type of columns in one floor, then you will not be able to take the advantage of precast. Everything has to be same. And as you repeat more, the cost of the whole construction comes down. So that is how you take advantage of precast. And what are the tower crane requirement? If you have a tall building, then you can go for a mobile tower crane. If you have a refinery structure or something as an industrial structure, then you can go for a mobile crane. Then how is the access? Are the roads wide enough? Will you be able to take the cranes there? Is it one odd building? So these are all the considerations that you should take. How much is the time that you have to produce this building? And finally, the structural connections of a precast element. Will it be suited? Can it be built in any place? So this is where Dextra comes in. And finally, the code compliance. And so these are the two parts, structural connections and the precast element is where Dextra comes in. So we will be discussing about it. So these are all the offerings from Dextra as well as structural connections are considered. So we primarily offer a grouted coupler. Grouted coupler, we have multiple forms of grouted coupler. We have threaded coupler and we have a fully grouted coupler. When we say threaded coupler, ideally one part of the coupler is threaded and one part you should connect it at the site. And when we say fully grouted coupler, it is rebars connected with a coupler and the medium of this connection became is by means of a grout. And we have regular threaded coupler, bolted coupler, headed anchors, and FRP. So we will be going into slides. We will try to explain how these are connected. So when you see a building, for say a residential building, so these are all the places where couplers can be used in walls, in load-bearing walls, in cladding curtain walls, in shear walls. And these are the places, lift walls, these are the places where grouted couplers are used. In grouted couplers, we have two varieties of it. One is L and one is S. When the element thickness is 90, 110, or it's a thin element, then we go for a slimmer version of our grouted coupler. When the element size are bigger, then we go with a larger version of our grouted coupler. And in IT buildings, which happens to be our main clientele, if you see, these are all the applications that you can do with them. You can have bar tie couplers to provide bar continuity in the beams. And if you have, you can have grouted S or L in the columns. And then you can have end anchors or headed bars in the junctions to avoid L anchorage. And grouted P is specific. Grouted P and AF couplers are fully grouted coupler. These are specific to wet connections in precast to provide bar continuity in that particular section. Okay, so, and this is one particular application where precast has been extensively used, pipe rack refineries. And in refineries, the fire rating has been updated and the concrete structures as such has become economical for them to use. So now if you see most of the refineries starting from Jamnagar refinery, most of the refineries are constructed in pipe racks, are constructed in concrete, in precast. So they speed up the project and it meets all the fire safety requirements. And these are the couplers that can be used there. These are end anchors can be used and similarly how couplers are used, grouted L or S, depending on the tolerances and dimensions that you have. This is how it is used. Further, we will just see a basic example of grouted coupler and how they are engaged. It's a video. Is the video playing? It's a building in Thailand. starting to 8 to 38 floors, it's precast. So this is a typical wall section. If you see, router couplers are at the bottom. So this is how a threaded connection works. And these are the inlet and outlet pipes. These vary according to the thickness of your section, be it column, be it wall, anything. And after casting that, this is what you will be able to see. So with the ceiling disc, without the ceiling disc, it can be installed. There are multiple route varieties we are compatible with. And this is how the grouting process happens. So this is an example of a precast building that we have done in Thailand, and we have done many such residential buildings in India as well. So when we talk about couplers, I was explaining about two types of grouted couplers. That is, one is a threaded coupler and one is a fully grouted coupler. Threaded couplers have thread at one end. It is as simple as that. And the rest of the bars are inserted at the side. So this is how a typical precast caging looks like. So you have a threaded coupler connection, and then the rest of the coupler is there, which becomes a part of your precast element, and then it is kept at your site and it is grouted. Whereas in fully threaded couplers, you have the coupler which is completely hollow, and this complete section has no thread. This coupler actually is meant in locations where there are less number of couplers, or in remote places where taking a machinery and putting it there would be difficult, or places where the project duration is slow. But anyway, they will be requiring grouted couplers. So this is specifically developed for that particular application. And if you see, grouted couplers can go either on the top or on the bottom. Means they can be pumped to fill the grout, or they can be in the inverted position where you have to pour the grout. So either way, the function of coupler remains same. So there is no effect in the working of coupler. It depends on the convenience. In practical applications, the coupler being on the top of element is usually done in residential buildings or in places where the element is very light, say within 10 tons. When your element becomes very heavy, like in pipe rack frames, where the frame itself will weigh around 40 to 50 tons, you will anyway have a trailing crane. And that way, these bars at the bottom can be lifted a little bit up, and then the whole element is lifted so that your bars don't bend. And you can directly keep the element and pour it. And having such a big element with like 40 couplers in one single column or 32 couplers in one single column, it would be very difficult to grout with a pumping machine. So gravity method is used. Okay. So we will be going into the next section. You can have just a little glimpse of how threading work is done on rebar. And there would be a dedicated machine at the site which does the threading work. We do three process. We do a process specific to Dextra. That is, we do a cold forging process in rebar, which does not reduce the cross-sectional area of rebar. We take the rebar, we cut it at 90 degrees. And then we force a rebar. For example, if it's a 25 dia rebar, we increase the dia to 30 plus and then we thread it. So the nominal cross section of the rebar does not reduce, and this ensures that it meets all the strength requirements. So the steel layers, that is Martin set and perlite, the idea is to preserve the harder layer. So the steel rebar reinforcement does not lose its strength. So this is how the rebar threading work is done. And these are all the machineries. And when I say threading, how threading work is done, this is a standard process that we have. And with this threading methodology, we can produce a very high number of threads, almost to the tune of 1,000-2,000 threads per day. And this machine is a heavy duty machine designed for cut and bend plants. And all the threads that we produce can be quality checked. We have this no and go, no go gauges. Since the threads that we produce are metric threads, there is a lower limit and upper limit for the threads that we produce. So all the threads that we produce can also be quality checked. So this ensures that the connection that you have is safe and sound and will produce the desired results. So how is it that the coupler is tested? So coupler are, there are multiple codes which dictate how the coupler should be tested and which says how the coupler should be tested and how they are used in various seismic zones. So there are multiple codes to it. There are IS-16172, which is an Indian code for coupler, which also covers grouted coupler. And there is the IS-16700, which is a tall building code for India, which says that any building above which uses rebar above 16 dia should use a coupler. And in addition to this, being a product which is global, means we don't design anything specific for India. It is a global product which is universally accepted. As I said, it's also an export hub. So we tested, it's one single coupler which is tested according to multiple different codes. We test it as per ISO, we test it as per ACI. And these are all the tests that that has been done for one particular coupler. So oligogolic cycle. This is specific in ISO 15835. And this is the only test which talks about reverse cyclic loading or how the coupler connection will behave in reverse cyclic loading. And this will mimic the seismic loading condition. So when we are talking about precast, we talk how precast buildings will be able to take seismic loads. So these are the tests which verify couplers to be used in seismic zones and in particular precast buildings. So Indian test is also there. There are 100 cycle tests, there are 10,000 cycle tests. And in addition to that, Dextro internally conducts angular misalignment and slip test also. Okay. So this is how the test is conducted. We put a casted coupler, means we take the rebar, we cast the joint along with the grout and we put it in a UTM machine. We subject it to 10,000 cycles. And after this 10,000 cycles also, the coupler should be withstanding the normal rebar strength, which it should meet the requirement of IS-1786, which is the rebar code. And this is how the reverse cyclic loading is done. So if you see, the coupler is tested in tension as well as in compression, and 20 cycles of tension and compression, which is up to 0.95 of your yield and 0.5 of your compression. So this is how it is tested. And further four cycles of two times of your yield and four times of your yield. So further it is subjected till the breaking point. So this is how a coupler is tested, and you will know that how it will perform in case of a seismic activity. And to very go into it, now everybody is using BIM modeling. And what Dextra has done is that we have created software templates for all the products that we have. So you can check it in your designs, whether the coupler will fit in your design or not. So that how that is done, we have templates and this is how it is done. You can see a short video of AutoCAD. We have similarly tools for AutoCAD, Tekla, Rivet. So these templates are readily available for designers. It's not a chargeable visit, it's free of cost. You just have to register in our website and it would be sent to you. The idea behind this is to directly go into the production mode and it speeds up your precasting process. So this is how the design, this is how we help in designing part of it. So how does Dextra differentiate itself from other people, or what does Dextra offer? So basically all the splice designs are done by Dextra. The machines that produce the threads are also manufactured by Dextra. Couplers are produced in-house by Dextra. The machine manufacturing process and the site operation work is also done by Dextra. The splice certification work is also done by Dextra. The whole responsibility of the connection remains with Dextra. So this is what we offer. So at Dextra, end to end, it's a closed loop process which ensures that the quality of the coupler and the connection remains intact. So there are some critical industrial examples of what we have done in India. There are many projects that we have worked with. We would like to highlight a few of them. This is CIDCO project in Mumbai. So it's approximately 50 odd buildings that we are working with. So this project, if you see, we are completing almost 10 buildings now. So all the buildings are around 13 to 15 floors. And this is an active project. You can see how many laborers are working. You cannot actually see the workers there, but this is an active project. And this kind of progress can be done in the time of COVID also. So we are supplying couplers for it, and being a tall building which crosses 50 meters, our couplers are used here. So this is Chennai's Silk showroom. So here also we have supplied couplers for all the inverted walls. So here couplers are getting used. And this is one more example of NLC Corporation in Chennai where couplers are being used. Here in particular, if you see this particular photo, the column in the bottom right corner, you can see all the coupler projections are coming from one end. This is typically meant for high risk buildings where in the corner, you don't have to put chajjas. You can grout through one end of the column, which is safe for everybody. So this kind of arrangement can also be done with a coupler. And Amaravati Judicial Park, here, the entire building, the construction time for this time frame for the structural unit was hardly 3 or 4 months, within which the project was completed, excluding the finishing work. So the conceptualization of this building was turned out from cast in situ to precast within 2 weeks. And then we were able to support and supply for this project. So this is in Amravati. We have worked with a lot many precasts, and this is express exclusive in Chennai. You see, some of the balls have almost 42 computers in one single line. So these are the type of connections that we can do. So this is RunVault project in Mumbai. If you consider, there are certain issues geographically. In Mumbai, it is rainy season, and most of the people would like to get out of the basement region as soon as possible before it rains, because once they are out of it, their construction speed will not be interrupted by rain or anything, which is typical to precast. So this is why they are using precast here. And this is Galaxy Tower. So far, this is the tallest precast building in India. It is 24-story building. And till 7th story, it is cast in situ. And after that, they had their plan set up complete. And this project was executed within a time frame of 11 months, the structural part of it. And if you see, the column size is around 1.3 meter by 1.3 meter per level. In per column, there are around 32 couplers, and per floor there are 67 columns. The whole building is around 1.2 million square feet, and this construction could happen only because of this speed we could attain only because of precast. So this building construction time is only 11 months. So such can be the fast of construction. So this is one more project, which is Aurobindo. It's 1.6 million square feet approx. And this construction is also around 12 months only. It is again 24-story building. And we were able to supply couplers for this project. So these are the tall buildings as if now in precast, tallest building in precast as if now in India. And Nalanda IT Park in Pune. So here also we have done the project, and it's a beautifully done project, and we have completed this project in a range of 1 year. So all the projects in precast, which is around 1.9 million or 1.2 million, 2 million, 3 million, these kind of big projects can also be completed in a very short duration with the use of couplers. And there are many projects, like in Hyderabad, we have done Microsoft building. So then again, this is also a short project. Within 1 year, we have completed it. Image Tower. You can just see the column sizes in the right side. So this kind of erection can easily be done with the grouted coupler. Erection hardly takes any time here. So there is an international reference for grouted coupler as well. We have in Forest City, Malaysia, there are multiple towers. These towers, all this project was planned with precast, and we were able to support this project with supply of couplers. And the average height of building is somewhere between 150 to 180 meters. So there are all the tall buildings were using grouted coupler as a connection. And these are some of the connections that you see. And this is how the caging looks like. And this is our slim version coupler. And this is how it is placed in a wall panel. Okay. And this is again some of the examples of the project that we have used in Bosch in Bangalore. And this is one unique concept wherein it's volumetric or 3D printed, 3D precast. Here, all kitchen and bathroom pods are cast as one single unit. And here for the kitchen pods, we have supplied couplers, and it goes in as one single unit. It's project in Mumbai. The ideal project is around 240 buildings, and the average height is around 24 floors. Now they have completed the mock-up building, and soon they will be going into the full scale of they will be launching full scale projects. So this is how it is connected. And when we talk about precast, there is always a query how it will perform in seismic condition or seismic zones. So there is Philippines is a highly seismic activity active zone. And here also, if you see, there is a mass housing concept, and they are using grouted connections for them. For their buildings. So we have been able to supply for this particular project. And when we talk about industrial structures, we have worked in extensively in Jamnagar refinery. We have supplied around almost 2 lakh couplers there for all the pipe support frames. So this is a 40 dia coupler, and this is how a pipe support frame looks like. So this is how the structure is. So if you can see here, it is in one single go, the connection H frame is brought up, and the corbel has been designed to take the dead load of the beams, and it has been placed in such a way. And then unitech couplers, bolted couplers are used to connect it in the beam locations. So there is an advantage. You cannot do this with the beam connections in cast in situ process, wherein you have to go step by step. When you go for a precast connection, you can proceed all three at same time, and it is just a wet connection at that particular joints. That arrangements can be done. Again, this is Ahmedabad metro station, where couplers have been used in some of the columns. This is one unique project. There is a box out section in between where the beam sections will come and connect later on. And it's a double tire column. And like that, a double tire or triple tire column can also be done. So it saves a lot of time, steel. This project was done in Amravati with Inventa. And now we are slowly entering the infrastructure phase. There is a lot of scope for water tanks in precast. Being a standardized structure, this is something precast can do very well. When the structure is standardized, all you have to do is repeat multiple times. And we are working on water tank projects in multiple locations now. So this is a 10 KL tank and this is a 100 KL tank. And whenever a structure is standardized, it becomes precast friendly. And we have to just take output out of the plant to make it economical. So this is one application we have recently done in Versova Creek Bridge, where couplers have been used for struts in the bridges. So this is the first type of application that we have done in India. Though in US, bridges with grouted couplers are very common. There is a dedicated website called Accelerated Bridge Construction, which gives out details about use of precast in bridge construction. It's a nice website to go through and look into. And we have done multiple buildings in other countries like UK, in Singapore. We have done many buildings, all with the grouted coupler connection. So there is Moteria Stadium also that we have worked with. This 40 meter Y column junctions, these beam junctions are connected with a grouted coupler. The beam being precast 40 meters, you cannot use any other type of coupler, because it has very little tolerance. Threaded coupler as such has a very little tolerance, and that is why they have gone with grouted couplers. And when we talk about precast, not everything is boxy. We can have other geometries also. This is one unique example of a precast building being circular in shape. It's done in UAE. If you can see, different other type of precast connections are not possible here. So this is how your grouted coupler connection is flexible. You can use it in any type of building, in any type of location. For example, this is the building, and this is how the elements are casted. And as we go deep into it, we will soon have retaining walls done with precast technology. And this is how all these difficult shapes can also be produced in precast with the use of couplers. So this is how the typical element looks like. and this is the end result. And where I talked about three layers of means not one or two level, but three levels of column. So here you can see one such column here where there are three levels here and erected in one single go. This is ideally suited for large format stores like in like big box retail or retail shops and things like that. So these are our clients. So we have worked with almost all the precasters in India, barring a few. We would like to associate with any precaster project and we would like to work with them. So this is about the presentation. I would be happy to answer any queries related to the Dextra precast connections.
Thank you, Mr. Satish. Chairman, sir. Hello. Unmute yourself, sir.
Yeah, you can take up the question and answer, Madhu.
Participant, those who want to ask questions can raise their hands in the using the facility in the app. And in the meantime, Mr. Satish, you have those questions which I had already sent to you.
Yes.
How these connections will behave during the earthquake?
See, I have covered this. When we talk about couplers are tested to specific parameters. And these are, there are codes specific to that. In India, there is a code for a coupler, which dictates how the coupler should be tested. And when we say tested, it is not just pull-out test. There are cyclical loads which are applied on a coupler connection, like 100 cycles and 10,000 cycle, low voltage cycle. So this is how we verify how the coupler connection will behave when a cyclic load comes or when a seismic load comes. So if you see in Indian code and in ISO specific, they have stated one oligocyclic code, which is basically testing the coupler up to 95% of the yield of the rebar, 90 to 95% of the yield of the rebar.
Okay.
To check how it will perform when a sudden load or a load till the yield, normally building is not designed for 95% of the yield. So you check it to the maximum load and check how it is performing. So this is the verification for it. And by since it has already been used in areas where it is seismic or like in Philippines or even in Mumbai, it is zone 3, I think. So in places like that, it is this system is verified. It's the Jamnagar refinery, the reference I'm taking, it's located in Gujarat, which again falls in the seismic zone.
Okay. Mr. Anirudhanappa, please unmute yourself. In the meantime, that second question, is any periodical grouting required for water retaining structure?
No. When we are talking about water retaining structure, our scope is limited to the connection. Now, once the coupler is grouted and when we have two precast elements, they are not connected as such. There is a sealing motor space in between them. And this space is all kept so that you can have verticality, you can adjust the zero-zero connections will not happen. And then again, it will become a dry joint. So you always have a space between two precasting elements. So this space along with the coupler and everything is grouted in one single go and it is done. So no further top up or anything can be done. It's all done in one single shot.
Okay. I think this is not relevant. Why lightweight aggregate are not being adopted, I think he wants to say. Why lightweight aggregate are not adopting by precast manufacturing?
I would not be able to
answer. Then can we use precast materials or components in the earthquake? I think this was not relevant. Can we use precast materials or components in the earthquake zone? That is not relevant. There is one question, I think, which is, what is the periodicity of maintenance of the joints?
Sir, as such, there is no periodicity. It is a part of your design. As you design your steel, steel and concrete, this becomes a part of your design. There is no such maintenance which is required for couplers.
Okay.
Sir, I have one question.
Yeah, Mr. Naka, please shoot.
Priyadarshan, sir, we can see that in Mumbai, it is mostly the coastal part. And now and then, again and again, we come across corrosion in structures and a lot of research is going on and there are solutions also. How can we address, if at all, there is any corrosion involvement in this, particularly in the couplers?
Sir, when we are talking about coupler or connection or corrosion, corrosion is usually covered by cover or the concrete cover that is given on the coupler. And as such, the coupler material is cast iron. It is not susceptible to coupler as mild as steel is, as rebar is. So this will be taken care by the concrete cover that we provide to the couplers.
Thank you, sir.
Mr. Suresh Chattopadhyay, please.
Good afternoon, Mr. Priyadarshan. How are you?
How are you, sir?
I'm good.
We recently met, I think.
yeah, we met. Only thing I have a issue here is you are doing a great job in testing of all the things like connection with the steel and other things. Only issue which I have is the who will take the responsibility of failure of the coupler? Because when you are doing the grouting, grout is not your supply. And that is the one of the main thing which is keeping it intact. So if suppose grout fails or your coupler fails, we don't know when we are using. So if one company takes responsibility of the coupler, then only it will succeed in the market in a very big way. Otherwise, what I feel, there will be always an apprehension about the, because when we are using grouts in double tubes, we can drill and check that, yes, the grout material is full or not. But in your case, we cannot drill also the thing. So how do you look into that type of issue of resolving those issues? I would suggest if with your coupler, if you can give a pouch of grout also, which is totally tested and certified by you, then it will be easier for anyone to use that.
That's one of the observations
which I have as a user of the coupler, because we find so many products of grouts. It is very difficult to choose the grout and take the responsibility of the grout.
I have taken your question. Sir, what we do is that we have been, any connection we are testing, we test with one particular grout or anything that we use and we test it. And then we say that you can use this particular grout. We don't suggest any grout. We suggest grout which we have tested. Like we have done 10,000 cycles with one particular grout, we suggest that this is good enough. It has withstood 10,000 cycles of our coupler joint, and then you can use it. Similarly, we suggest our own qualification standards that we have within Dextra. Grout manufacturers supply grout to us. We test it as a coupler connection, and then we suggest that this is okay. You can use this.
So, do you take responsibility of any failure which happens after this is grouted?
Sir, when you say that, means taking responsibility, of course, it becomes a part of coupler. But then there are how you are grouting it, how you are mixing it. These are all the concerns that needs to be addressed.
That is
and
nothing.
Which
who
is
takes,
done?
That is my question.
Okay. Ideally, sir, I would not pinpoint it in that manner. Means it becomes a grout connection, and then coupler is also a part of it. But as such, as a system to work, everything should be a part of it. Means design, the steel, the rebar, the grout, all these things comes into part of it. So the, what we can do is that we can ensure that grout that you are using is properly implemented at site. That is what we can do. And we Thank provide you. Specific trainings to it, and during your first casting or first erection, Dextra becomes a part of it and implements the system which has to be followed by the team for rest of the project. That we do.
Dipati sir, unmute yourself. Dipati sir, unmute yourself.
Anyhow, your presentation was good and very informative. Thank you very much.
Thank you. Mr. Sushil Agarwal.
Yes, sir. Yes, tell me the presentation.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir. I'm very happy to know that you are doing some work on overhead water tanks. Well, this is one neglected area in construction activities. Now, I would like to know where we can we visit some places where near Pune or Mumbai, where you are this overhead water tank?
Sir, some of this water tank, precast water tanks have been a recent concept. And some of the examples are in Tamil Nadu. And there is a huge project which is going on in Uttar Pradesh.
Okay.
So you will be able to see these examples in Uttar Pradesh and Tamil Nadu, but not so far in Mumbai, in Mumbai or Maharashtra area. Yes, Uttar Pradesh as such has a lot of development to do, and they have a lot of scope for repetition and a lot of tanks. So that's how it is starting there. And we will be able to see this trend soon in rest of the India also.
Yes, sir. Agarwal sir, you have muted yourself.
Hello. Can you give the reference of work going on in Uttar Pradesh, where we can see this?
Now you can see in Varanasi. Varanasi, the production is going to start, and within 1 month, you will be able to see a few tanks there.
So, who is the right person to get in touch, in contact with in this regard?
Sir, we have the contacts. It is actually done by L&T, and there are a few other companies which are also doing it. So we will be able to share the contact. We post this presentation, we will be able to share it.
Sure, okay, sir. Thank you. Thank you very much.
Thank you, sir. Mr. Muralidhar Khattar.
Yeah. Okay. I have got two questions. One is, how much time do you save by doing this precasting? Number one, and how much extra cost is there for the system compared to the normal construction?
Sir, ideally, precast. If you see square feet to square feet, it is around 1,200 per square feet, 1,200 to 500, depending on the grade of concrete and all these things. And if the element is very high, very heavy, and then you have to use a bigger tower crane, then it goes to touching beyond 4,450, 500, that range it will come. It is costlier than your conventional system, but the speed, if you see, I would take the example of Aurobindo, where they had a cycle time of to erect 67 columns and beams and proceed to the next level. They had a cycle time of around 14 days. So every 2 weeks or 1 week, they would erect 70 columns and they will proceed with the next level. So this is the speed that you can see. Even in SIDCO project in Navi Mumbai, they have completed around 13 floors in 10 buildings in a duration of 11 months. So this is the speed that you will get to see. And this is something which is limited by the tower cranes. If you employ more tower cranes, this will be even faster only.
Okay, so that using more tower cranes means more cost also. So you got to also balance.
Yes, yes. It is a balance that you will have to maintain, because
how much extra one should be ready to pay for this type of system? Of course, you can save some time. There is no doubt about that. But then how much do you think? 10%, 15%, 12%?
It would be, sir, it would be in the range of 10 to 20%. And the advantage that you get is that you will have more sellable floor space.
Okay.
So that is a balance that you will have to match to see if it is cost effective or not. And when you say it is a precast building, it's something like a turnaround time that you will have to consider. Okay. And how fast do you want the building to be ready? And basically it goes into that, how fast do you want the buildings to be ready? And how many towers are you doing with one single precast plant? If it is more number of projects that you are doing, then automatically the cost will come down. And this is kind of subjective. You would not be able to point a finger on this. Sometimes precast will become far more effective. There are cases where there are 53 towers or 54 towers, all with one same design, which is copy pasted everywhere. And this is done in a duration of 4 years.
Anyway, that's all right. And then, you have cast in situ construction also, where people say with the shuttering being used, you can get a 7 or 10 day cycle per floor. And that is what is being done based on whatever the scheme is. And that is actually cast in situ. And then compared to that is your precast, what we are describing. So the comparison should be between the two as to how much saving you can make by going for precast. And there is one more thing which precast so far, I don't know about your system, that the problem of leakage remains. If you see all other precast works which have been done, the problem arises about the leakage of water through the joints. So how do you avoid that?
Yeah, yes, sir. Now this particular problem has been addressed by builders. Now if you see in SIDCO project, they are flooding the entire flat and checking leakage. They are specifically doing it to avoid leakage. And this problem is, there are multiple ways to address this problem. If you see, we are running a project in Seaboard Carver, which is exposed to rain, heavy rain. And here, if you see, there are provisions given in the building, like chaja sort of a thing, which is coming along with your wall panels, so that there is no rain penetration in the building itself. So there are multiple approaches to that, and these are controlled by designs.
Thank you, sir.
Mr. Ravindra Rangsha, please.
Well, it's a very informative talk I had today. I have few. I have two questions. One is that, can this coupler be used in cast in situ structures? Because there are many structures coming out. I'm looking after some of the metros and tunneling projects in Bombay. So, can we use it for cast in situ structures? This particular
Sir,
ground.
This coupler is ground. Not meant for cast in situ building. It's meant for precast.
Okay.
In cast in situ, there are rare examples where it has been used for retrofitting or temporary stitching, means stitching concrete, that kind of a thing. But you have economical solutions in cast in situ, like fully threaded coupler. This precast coupler, this grouted coupler is meant for precast buildings only.
Okay. And then I've seen in the presentation that these couplers are used in one level, one cross section of the structure.
Yes.
Is that okay?
Yes. Yes, that is okay, sir. If you take the reference of ACI 318, it gives, there is a provision to use a coupler on the same section if it is able to provide 125% of your rebar strength. And as such, any precast connection will be on the same section only, be it welded connection, be it towel tubes, be it any type of precast connection will be on the same section only. It will not be staggered.
Okay. Thanks.
Mr. Anudanakwa, would you like to ask this one? Mr. Suresh Tripathi has raised his hand. Would you like to ask your question along with your concluding remarks? Mr. Anudanakwa.
Yeah, if there is someone asking
the Mr. Suresh Tripathi, unmute yourself and shoot, please.
Suresh Tripathi.
Actually, there was a question asked here about the precast, because since I am from the precast industry, I just wanted to say that if you are doing a 20-story building in precast, in cast, in shear wall and hollow core and combinations, your cost comes down to around less than 10%. It will be around 10% cheaper than your cast in situ. This has been proven because I was head of the precast for Supertech in Delhi. So we had done and we had taken up all the costs, every cost. And one of the major factors in precast which you save is handing over costs. Because these buildings are handed over in a much shorter time and these buildings are much cleaner and with less, what do you call, and maintenance cost. Basically, nobody gives due respect to the maintenance which is required in other things. So, since I was there from the precast fraternity, I just thought of just adding to what Mr. Priyadarshan was telling.
Thank you very much.
About the leakage, there are a lot of, earlier, yes, there were issues of the leakage, but technologies has improved. Earlier, what had happened, we were copying the thing technology from the Europe and doing the things. But in India, the temperatures and the systems and other things are different. So we with the time, we have graduated enough. And now most of the buildings which we are doing, we have even changed the methodologies of the, what do you call, the joints and other things. So now these type of issues are not coming. So precast, anybody can adopt with the full confidence, precast can be adopted. That's my say.
Thank you very much.
Suresh Tripathi ji, I agree with you. It is a dust-free and environment-friendly.
Oh,
yes, sir. Yes, sir. It's, and one of the major thing is that since you are doing it in factory, sir, so it is much safer also. And whatever you are doing at the ground level. And when you are taking it erect, and the erection is being done by a specialist people. So whatever you are sending from the factory, you are assured of the quality of the material which you are sending. Whenever you are doing cast in situ work, you are not 100% sure. There was one of the incident I will tell you. They were doing Maiwand shuttering and doing the things. At one level, the concrete cube failed after 28 days. Then the project was stalled for so much of time for getting certain that level what is to be done for that. So all those issues do come. So precast has its own very good advantage. So I think the future is there in the precast.
Thank you, sir. Mr. Anirudh Nakka.
Yeah, it was a very nice evening and lecture presentation by Dextra India Private Limited.
Sir, you are not audible.
Not audible. Now?
Yeah.
Now I am audible?
Yes. Mr. Sathya, you are not able to hear him? We are able to hear him.
Yeah. Yes. Recording me hai na.
Mr. Satish, can you hear me? You are muted yourself.
I think you should be able to hear me.
I am hearing. I am able to hear you. Chairman, sir? Please go ahead.
Yeah. Thanks, Madhusudan and Chairman, for allowing me to do this responsible job of giving.
Mr. Anirudh, 1 minute. I think Mr. Bhargav Jog and Mr. Satish, you are having some issues. Mr. Jog.
Yes, we can hear you.
Mr. Satish was not able to hear.
Yes, can you hear was some technical glitch, maybe. Yeah.
I'm sorry, I'm not able to hear you.
Even now?
Yeah. So, webinar on role of Dextra Grouted Connection in Precast Construction by Dextra India Private Limited. A very nice presentation by Sri Satish Priyadarshan. He covered the topics from type of precast connections and their constraints in various types of connections, advantages of Dextra Grouted Connections. He also gave referrals to grouted couple connections, including the latest one, which he referred for ACI 318. Software tools, how they developed and designed, involving AutoCAD. We can overall see Dextra has taken precision of technology to a micro level. We see structures, concrete and reinforcement over the years, but the extended development of precast concrete elements with scientific approach at micro level is seen through overall presentation.
the versatility of this mechanical splicing designed for precast concrete elements is used in concrete industry was very nicely explained in detail. How the technology was evolved right from the Industrial Revolution, designed and brought into reality was very well delivered to us. How extra Gravtech is used in various connections of residential, commercial, and industrial buildings, including the high rises. Moreover, how it was used for precast bridge girders. Flexibility of couplers was also explained in detail. How Gravtech and other materials, including couplers, etc., are used in precast concrete element connection was explained very precisely, and how Dextra has achieved excellence in this technology. We here really appreciate Dextra's contribution in research, development, manufacturing, and installation of precast concrete members to the precision. On behalf of Builders Association of India, Mumbai Center, and All India, I thank for this wonderful presentation by Shri Satish Priyadarshan on behalf of Dextra India Private Limited. I thank all the honorable dignitaries of Builders Association of India, All India, and our local chapter. Also, I thank Communication Head Madhusudan Sanjeeva for communicating and having this wonderful lecture. I especially thank our Chairman Mumbai Center, Mohinder Rizwani, to take initiative for all such lectures. And I hope this noble initiative is helping many of us and will keep on helping the learners, students, as well as the industry people. How can I forget all the participants who are here, who are listening this lecture quite with patience and responding to us. Thank you so much. And with a note of Merry Christmas and Happy New Year 2022 to all of you, I thank you here from Builders Association of India. Thank you once again.
Thank you, sir. Thank you, Mr. Satish. This was also live on YouTube simultaneously. And thank this you, will go on our YouTube channel also, the video, edited video. Mr. Okay. Joke, thank you very much. Mr. Joke, I think he's there. Yeah. And Mr. Sushil Agarwal, I'll give you the contact detail of Mr. Bhargav Joke. You can talk to him regarding that. You want to see the water tank in Uttar Pradesh. I think maybe he is not there. Mr. Satish, thank you very much.
Thank you, sir. Thanks a
lot. Everybody can unmute themselves, those who want.
Thank you, PAI and all the respected dignitaries for giving us this opportunity. It was really good. For quite a long time, we were planning this session.
Yeah.
And hopefully we had a good interaction. We plan to have many similar sessions with PAI. Thank you, sir, for coordinating.
You can send articles also for printing in our journal regarding this. Mr. Priyadarshan, sure. Mr. Jog.
Yes.
You can send up articles which we can print in our journal.
Certainly.
Thank you for this opportunity. I'll mention this to you in your message or an email.
Yes.
Thank you very much.
Thank you very much. Thank you, all of you. Merry Christmas and Happy New Year.
Take care. Suresh Ripati, have very nice questions.
Right. Thank you.
Happy New Year, sir.
Mr. Soam, thank you.
I have used Dextra material in Bangladesh.
Okay. Oh, you are from Bangladesh. You are speaking from Bangladesh. Yeah, I had a message from you. You are joined us from Bangladesh.
I have used Dextra material in Bangladesh.
Okay. Achha, which project?
In JT project.
Okay.
Very nice.
It is very good.
Oh, thank you very much.
Yeah, it is. There's no doubt.
Thank you, sir.
Okay. Thank you, sir.
Thank you, everybody. Thank you for joining us, sir.
Home, sir, please join us every time. Thank you, sir.
Okay, sir.
I'm closing it. I'm ending it.
Okay, bye, sir.
Mr. Satish, thank you. Mr. Joke, thank you once more.
Thank you. Take care, everybody.
Yeah.
Happy New Year, sir.
Happy New Year to everybody. Thank you.
Bye. See you. Happy New Year.